What's new in accessibility at Google? Hi, everyone. It's Laura Allen again, Head of Strategy and Programs for Accessibility and Disability Inclusion here at Google. Welcome back to another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility, a series where every few months, we tell you about new ways that we're making our products and features more accessible for everyone. In this episode, we'll talk about accessibility updates coming to Pixel, Maps, Search, Chrome, and more. First up, we're growing the Google Accessibility Trusted Tester Program. For years, our program has been available in the US and Canada. Now we're expanding to the United Kingdom. Accessibility Trusted Testers have the opportunity to try out new Google products before the broader public and share their feedback directly with our user experience researchers. Trusted testers play a vital role in helping us build products that work for everyone. If you're interested in being a trusted tester, you can learn more at g.co/a11yTT. And if you're located outside of the US, Canada, or the UK, you can still sign up for user research at google.com/user research. In Pixel News, we've released some exciting updates and features to support people in the blind and low vision community. Magnifier is a Pixel camera-based app that allows you to zoom in on something like you would using a physical magnifying glass. You can also adjust the contrast, color filters, and brighten the camera based on your vision needs. The app was designed in collaboration with trusted partners at the Royal National Institute of Blind People and the National Federation of the Blind. Magnifier can be useful in a lot of different situations, like when you're reading a menu in a dimly lit restaurant, or viewing street signs at a distance, or even zooming in on a concert main stage from far away. As someone who has low vision, I can honestly say that I've been using this app almost daily and have found it so useful. Magnifier is available on Google Play for Pixel 5 or higher, excluding the Pixel Fold. In more Pixel news, we recently released Guided Frame 2.0, the newest version of our AI-powered camera feature that aims to help blind and low vision users like me capture selfies with a combination of precise audio cues, high contrast animations, and haptic feedback. Now, Guided Frame recognizes more than just faces. With the 2.0 version, you can use your front and rear facing camera to take photos of your pets, your dinner, or even your documents. This update is already available on Pixel 8 and Pixel 8 Pro and is rolling out to more models soon. To learn more, check out the video we created with Lachi, a recording artist and cultural activist who identifies as blind.
3, 2, 1. Photo taken.
She demos Guided Frame and explains what this feature means to her and to others in the blind community. We'll link to the full video in our YouTube notes. On Maps, we've launched new features that make some daily tasks easier and more accessible. First, we released new screen reader capabilities that pair with Lens in Maps. Lens in Maps uses AI and augmented reality to help people discover new places and orient themselves in an unfamiliar neighborhood. Now, if your screen reader is enabled, you can tap the camera icon in the search bar, lift your phone, and you'll receive auditory feedback about the places around you.
Restaurant Cane, fine dining, 190 feet.
Like ATMs, restaurants, or transit stations. And that includes helpful information like the name and type of the place or thing and how far away it is. We're also adding accessible walking routes to Google Maps on iOS and Android to surface step-free directions. Accessible walking routes can be helpful for people who use wheelchairs, crutches, or other mobility aids, as well as for people who are traveling with luggage or strollers. This feature was already available for transit directions, but now you can search for step-free walking routes all around the world just by toggling on Wheelchair Accessible under Route Options. Another feature we're really excited about is our new Disabled-Owned Business Attribute. It makes it easier for you to find and support businesses owned by people with disabilities. When businesses based in the US choose to identify as disabled-owned in their business profile, the attribute will appear in their listings on Maps and Search. This builds on our existing business attributes, which include Asian-owned, Black-owned, Indigenous-owned, Latino-owned, LGBTQ+-owned, veteran-owned, and women-owned. On Android, we've added a new way to customize assistant routines. Routines help you access information and customize your daily tasks using the Google Assistant. You can now customize your routine's home screen shortcuts by adding your own images, captions, and by adjusting the size of the shortcut. Research has shown that personalization like this can be particularly helpful for people with cognitive differences and disabilities. We hope that this makes assistant routines helpful for even more people. Last but not least, on Chrome, we've made it more efficient to search with the Chrome address bar. Earlier this year, we introduced a new feature in the Chrome address bar on desktop that detects typos and displays suggested websites based on what Chrome thinks you meant. This can improve accessibility for people with dyslexia, language learners, and anyone who makes typos by making it easier to get to previously visited websites despite spelling errors. We've now expanded this feature to Chrome on Android and iOS, so you have the same experience across all your devices. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. We hope you've enjoyed learning about some of our latest efforts to improve our accessibility products and features. If you want to learn more, sign up for our accessibility newsletter at g.co/a11y/news, or by clicking the link in the description of this video. Until next time, what's new in accessibility at Google?